गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल इन द लास्ट क्लास आई टॉट यू अबाउट द बेसिक इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द बैलेंसिंग राइट इन दिस क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अबाउट द प्रॉब्लम इन द बैलेंसिंग ऑफ रोटेटिंग मास रीड द प्रॉब्लम ए बी सी एंड डी आर फोर मासेस कैरिड बाय अ रोटेटिंग शाफ्ट एट रेडी 100 mm 125 200 एंड 150 mm रेस्पेक्टिवली द प्लेट्स आर The planes in which the masses revolve are spaced 600 mm apart. The mass of B, C and D are 10 kg, 5 kg and 4 kg respectively. Find the required mass A and the relative angular settings of the four masses so that the shaft shall be in complete balance. Right? The problem is given. The problem is given four masses, four different masses, that is A, B, C and D, right? In this, they given the radius, revolving radius, that is A will revolve 100 mm, B will revolve 125 mm, C will revolve at 200 mm, D will revolve at 150 mm, right? And also, these planes are spaced. The planes are, these are the planes, right? These planes are spaced between 600 mm apart. So, every planes, gap between the every planes, 600 mm. A to B, 600 mm, B to C, 600 mm, C to D, 600 mm. Right? This is the condition they given. Then, they given the mass of B, C and D are 10 kg, 5 kg and 4 kg. So, they given the mass of plane B, C and D. B, C, D. Right? They didn't given the value of mass as A. Right? 10, 5, 4. Then, find the required mass A. We need to find the mass of A. And relative angular settings of four masses. They didn't mention any kind of angular settings in these planes, right? They didn't mention the angular settings. We need to identify the angular settings here. Then, so that the shaft shall be in complete balance. We need to identify the angular settings to attain the complete balance condition. That is the main important thing, right? How you can find? First, we need to draw a position of plane diagram. First, we need to draw a position of plane diagram. How we can draw means with a problem. Problem data, given data only we can able to draw this diagram. They given the four planes A, B, C and D. So, we can directly draw a shaft. This is the shaft. In this, we have a four mass, right? Four planes. So, A, B, C, D. We can mark that. Then, they mentioned the planes are spaced between 600 mm apart. So, every plane have a space 600 mm that we need to draw. Then, here we didn't know any other values. Only we know the radius values, right? Directly we need to go to the table. We need to go to the table. We need to make this table. Wherever we need to solve this balancing rotating mass problem, we need to put this table directly. Plane, mass, radius, centrifugal force per omega square, set distance from reference plane, coupled per omega square. Right? Why we are using this centrifugal force per omega square and coupled per omega square? These planes are arranged in single shaft, right? Single shaft. So, the shaft will rotate in the same speed. That means constant speed. So, there is no speed difference between the planes. Speed difference between the planes. That's why we are using this centrifugal force per omega square and coupled per omega square. Right? Planes. What are the planes available? A, B, C, D. Right? Then, what about the mass? Mass of A, we don't know. So, directly we can write MA. Then mass of B, they given 10 kg. mass of C 5 kg, mass of D 4 kg, right? Then radius, what about the radius for every planes? First plane 100 mm, we need to substitute in the meter, so 10^-3, so we get the 0.1 meter. Then radius of C, B, radius of B 125 mm divided by 1000, 0.125 meter. 200 mm for C, so divided by 1000, 0.2 meter. Finally D 150 mm divided by 1000, 0.15 meter. Right? After this, how you can find the central force per omega square? The column itself, we wrote the formula M into R. Already we know the M and R values. Then we can multiply this. So that we get the multiplication and find the values. That is 0.1 mg. 10 × 0.125, we get the 1.25. 5 × 0.2, 1. 4 × 0.15, 0.6. Right? After this, we need to find the distance from reference plane. For that, we need to identify the reference plane first. How you can select the reference plane? How you can select means, where is the unknown values there? Which plane have unknown values? That plane, we can mostly set that the reference plane, right? Why means, then only we can able to find that value very easily. That's why. Okay, right? So I'm going to consider A plane as a reference plane. Why means, we need to find the value of mass of A. So that I am going to consider A as a reference plane. Right? Then I am going to find the value of distance from reference plane. What's the distance from reference plane to A? This is a reference plane. So there is no distance. So zero. Right? This is a reference plane. A plane is the reference plane. A to A don't have distance. Right? So the value will be zero. Then we need to find that distance from reference plane to B. B to reference plane. What's the value? 600 mm. So 600 divided by 1000, 0.6 meter. Then C to reference plane, 1200 mm, we get the 1.2 meter. D to reference plane, 1800 mm divided by 1000, 1.8 meter. Right? Finally, we need to find the coupled per omega square value. How you can find that value? We need to multiply the centrifugal force per omega square value and distance from reference plane value. What means, coupled per omega square formula will be mr into l. Right? Already we found that m into r value here, and l value here we wrote. So finally we can multiply this and get the coupled per omega square value. First one we can multiply 0.1 mg × 0. Finally we got the value 0. Right? Then 1.25 × 0.6, we get the value 0.75. 1.2 × 1.2, 0.6 × 1.8, 1.08. These are the values we got. Right? After this, we need to draw the force polygon and coupled polygon values. Force polygon and coupled polygon diagrams. How we can draw these diagrams? First we need to check the columns. Centrifugal force per omega square column as well as coupled per omega square column. Right? Y means, which one have minimum unknowns? Right? That we need to check. Centrifugal force per omega square column have one unknown value. Ma, 0.1 mg. right? Remaining are numerical value only. In the coupled pair omega square column, we didn't have the unknown value. We didn't have the unknown value. So I am going to draw the coupled polygon diagram. Coupled polygon diagram with the help of coupled pair omega square value. Right? Coupled pair omega square value. Here we have a plane. A plane value is the zero. So next value. What is the next value? For B plane, the 0.75. Can you draw 0.75 in the sheet? No, it's not possible, right? And also 1.2 and 1.08 is there. This also very minimum value. We can't able to draw exactly, right? So we need to take the scale ratio. We need to take the scale ratio. How you can take the scale ratio? For the suitable scale ratio for drawing. For the suitable scale ratio for drawing. How means? We need to draw the diagram with the help of this scale. Here I am going to take the scale 0.25 kilogram meter square is equal to 1 centimeter. In the coupled polygon, 0.25 kilogram meter square equal to 1 centimeter. So we can draw. Here we will get the 3 centimeter. 0.75 divided by 0.25. Finally we got the 3 centimeter. Here we will get the 4.8. Here we will got the 4 point something, right? Here finally we can draw this diagram very simple manner, right? Very simple and very neatly. How we can draw this? Here we didn't know the values. We didn't know the angular settings. We didn't know the angular settings, right? For that, I am going to draw a horizontal line for this length, for this distance, right? I am going to mark the point O and draw a horizontal line for this length, 0.75. 0.75 divided by 0.25, the value will be 3 centimeter, right? For that length, I am going to draw a horizontal line. Horizontal line, that point is B. This is the B plane, right? So I am going to give the name B, right? Then take the compass and convert the value in the scale. 1.2 divided by 0.25. What we get? Take that value in the compass and locate the compass at the B and mark the arc here, right? Then D point. What's the value of D? 1.08 divided by 0.25. What we'll get? That we can take the compass and locate the compass at O and make the arc. The junction point is the C. Right? Why we are putting like this means they asked to use the complete balance condition. Right? Asked to use the complete balance condition. So we are using this condition, right? Then we need to mark this angle. How you can mark means this is a horizontal position, right? So I am to mark the angular position here. This is the origin O. Here I am going to draw a horizontal line B, right? Then this is a parallel to the BC. In the coupled polygon diagram, parallel to the BC, I am going to draw a line here. a line here. I mark the name and parallel to the CO and draw a line. Draw a line, right? Then we need to draw a diagram. We need to draw a post polygon diagram. How we can draw? With the help of these values, we need to draw. Already we drawn the parallel lines to the BC and CO here, and mark, check the angular POI value, angle value, right? The angle value will be 100 degree and 240 degree, 100 degree and 240 degree, right? After this, we need to draw the force polygon diagram with the help of centrifugal force per omega square value, right? How you can draw this diagram? Here also we have the 1.25, 1, 0.6. Can you draw these values with the diagram? Can you draw a diagram with these values? No, it's not possible. It will be very, very, very small, right? Small value. So we can't able to draw this diagram with these values. So we need to use the scale ratio to enlarge the diagram. Right? So how we can take this scale ratio here? Here also I am going to take the 0.5 kilogram meter equal to 1 centimeter. 0.5 kilogram meter equal to 1 centimeter, right? Here also we don't know the value of A plane, right? So in the previous one, we started the horizontal plane as a B. So here also I am going to consider a origin point O. From that I am going to draw a horizontal line with a A plane, a B plane value, 1.25 divided by 0.5. That is 2.5, right? For that we need to draw a horizontal line. That point is B. Then draw a parallel line to the C. Draw a parallel line to the C plane with the value of C. C divided by 1 divided by 0.5. So the value will be 2. Right? After that, we need to draw a line diagram for D plane, 0.6 divided by 0.5, right? 1.2, and the value will be 1.2. This we can draw for this D plane, parallel to the D plane. We need to draw a parallel line to this D plane from the C point, and the distance will be 0.6 divided by 0.5. The value will be 1.2, right? Mark that. At the end, there is a gap. So we need to connect that. We need to connect the point O to D with the dotted line, and measure that value and convert this scale. The converted value will be 0.7 kilogram meter square. Kilogram meter square. Right? Already we know 0.1 MA. It's equal to the 0.1 MA, right? So we can equate this and find the value of mass of A. Plane A. The value will be 7 kg. After this, we need to check all the angular positions and also draw a parallel line to the D to O in this angular position diagram, and measure the angular values. I have measured the angle from the B plane. The theta D value will be 100 degree, theta A value will be 155 degree, and theta C value will be 240 degree, right? This is the angle B, this is the plane B, this is the plane D, this is the plane A, this is the plane C. The B to D value will be 100 degree. B to A value will be 155 degree. B to C value will be 240 degree, right? Here the system will be balanced, right? In the next class, I will teach you about another one most important problem. Thank you.